the show, which will probably pretty much be our first topic of the show every time because it's such a dynamic thing to do because all of us are powerful women. Women in the NFL! Let's go! Women in the NFL, I am super excited because we have a special, special segment today where we're going to dive into some special women that are in the NFL that you may not know about. So, we got women coaches for the Tampa Bay Bucs!
My team!
As you know, we do have a Buccaneers guru on the show. So, Kate, take it over.
So, I'm covering Lori Locust, and sorry if I botch her name. I'm trying to say it right. Maral, Javadifar. And Lori Locust is the assistant defensive line coach for the team. She's 57 years old, and she is not the only player like Tom Brady to play in her 40s. She actually started her football career at 40 years old. Wow. And she played on the women's league, and she played defensive line the team she played for, and then she ended up coaching for them. She was an intern for the Baltimore Ravens. So she's got an extensive football career, and the really cool thing about her is that a lot of the males on the team are very intimidated by her.
Yes.
I love it. Of interviews and like things that she's done with the team. And one of the biggest things is she worked on, we all know Ndamukong Suh has a very jaded history, and she really worked on that with him when he came to the Bucs and worked on his demeanor and how he acts on the field and how to react to plays and everything. So she's been really intricate with those men. Devin White finds her very intimidating. So she has a lot of good things, and she had to retire from her football career because she had a knee injury that ended her career. So that's when she shifted into the coaching. But the only sad thing is like most assistant coaches in the NFL don't make a lot, and especially women. So that's another thing we need to work on is their pay, getting them paid what they're worth.
Yes.
So the highest rate for an assistant coach in the NFL right now is like $72,000, where you have all these coaches making millions.
Right.
So, because like right now, Maral Javadifar is only worth $120 million when you look, or $120,000, sorry. But when you look at what all these other players are worth and all of these coaches that are coordinators and head coaches are worth, we need to work on pay scales.
Yeah,
I mean, especially for the women. But Maral's parents defected from Iran in the early 80s. She was born here in 1990. So their family didn't come until like the 80s. So she's Middle Eastern background. Mm-hmm. She is also one. Lori and Maral are the two first female coaches to ever win a Super Bowl, too.
Yeah.
They both joined the team in 2019. They've only been with the team 3 years. And she is the assistant strength and conditioning coach for the Buccaneers. So she works on all the off-the-field stuff when they're injured and everything, getting them back into playing condition. So both women are very dynamic. And what's interesting is with her, she has got a basketball background. Mm-hmm. So not even like the strong football background like Lori has. And she's very versed in a lot of different physical therapy background and just very cool women. And I've watched interviews with both of them, and the men really respect them on the team. And Bruce Arians can't speak highly enough of both of them.
That's awesome.
So I am very proud to say that the Buccaneers are also have another female who is in football research for the team as well. And the diversity is also very cool. She's one of the females that is black for them, which their four coordinators are the only four coordinators in the NFL that are black as well. So a lot of diversity in the Buccaneers, which I'm very proud of. Mm-hmm. So I'm proud of these women, and I'd love to hear if you ladies research them, what you think of them. So, Delilah, I know you're good at researching.
Yeah. Well, I did talk about them before, and I did, especially Maral, because she's a woman of color. And so with my other segment, in the other show, you know, I do DWD, which is Diversity with Delilah, and I did cover Lori Locust, and I covered Maral as well. And I actually, like, it's not so much she was just a basketball player. She played for an NCAA team. So even if she did come from a basketball background, she played for a good team. She played for Pace University. And so basically she has a sports background, right? So that means she actually does know about strengthening and conditioning, what you need to be on the field, right? She knows not just as a physical therapist and the fact that she has a medical background in that, but that she actually plays sports, right? So she understands also as an athlete herself what's needed to condition your body, right, in order to perform at a high caliber.
Absolutely.
And so what I'm enjoying about this is that it's not just like, oh, well, I'm hiring you just to fill this spot, but these women are earning their mm-hmm. positions and they played sports, right? I love that, you know, Lori Locust played football as a defensive end. Absolutely. Right? So the fact that that's what she does as a coach, she knows what she's talking about, which I am not surprised that she intimidated all the men on that team because she knows defense, right? That's exactly Absolutely. What she used to play. And so she's telling them like, hey, like buck up, like what you're doing, right? They're going to listen. And so that's what I really, really love about when we hear these hires is they weren't just given to them because they're trying to like fill a diversity quota. These women earn their spots and they deserve their flowers. Okay, like they deserve their flowers.
Absolutely, man. That is awesome.